Hello and welcome back to Lookster Gaming. So what I've got here today is actually a different Minecraft video, or well, I say different Minecraft video, different from the Looksercraft. This is all to do with villagers, and you'll notice the game's a bit laggy, which you'll soon find out why. That's not the video, this is the game. It genuinely has the start to it. Oh, and that iron golem's actually managed to grab himself a flower, or a rose, should I say. That wasn't like that before. And yeah, so basically what this is like a similar build to what official Nerd Cube once done. So, I think it was 3 or 4 years back actually, where, like, I don't know if he was the original one that done this, or this might have been like something that he saw and then sort of replicated on video. And basically, if you do this setup on the PC, it's for infinite villager breeding sort of thing, and the breeding requires that you sort of, well, because I'm doing this in creative, it's a lot easier to just sort of grab some emeralds, fly down here to a villager, sort of trade through, and sort of try and get them to breed by just like doing trades with various villagers. And yeah, I don't know where villager number one is, but I named them as I was, well, I didn't actually name them as I was going along, so it was only when I got like to the point where they couldn't breed, or towards that point where I actually sort of started naming them to try and keep track a bit. And yeah, I think I named one of the iron golems as well. One of them's called Iron Man, he may be round the back. And there's a lot of horses and things. But yeah, this is a sort of super flat creative world that's had the time of day locked in place. And you'll notice, well, 36. The reason he's called Villager 36S is because he was spawned in. Like, this was, I think they got to either, I think it was 35 they got to when they stopped actually breeding. Are you Iron Man? Nope. Hang on, sidetracked. And that one, for some reason, I think I managed to right click a name tag on the Iron Golem accidentally, so he's a villager, apparently. But yeah, as I was saying it, oh, where's he gone? Villager. There we are. So yeah, once it got to the point where they could no longer sort of naturally breed through trading, like, I must have spent hours, doing this anyway, and then it got to the point where they just didn't seem to be expanding in population, despite sort of doing all the mathematical calculations to actually work out that sort of the amount of doors here, because it's to do with the amount of doors is the reason why there's so many. Like, sort of the amount of doors, I can't remember the exact, like, what it was again, because it was actually some months ago I done this, and I'm only now getting around to recording it. But yeah, it worked out to where the number of doors here should give at least sort of 2 or 3 times the amount of villagers, so maybe like over 100 villagers. But because there's a villager cap on both the 360 and even the Xbox One version, then that's as far as the bread. And I decided to make, I think, like, villager, I got a spawn egg for villager 36S and villager 37S, wherever he's about. Ah, there you are, villager 37S, speak of the devil. So yeah, villager 36S, villager 37S. The S standing for spawn, because they were spawned in with a spawn egg. And spawned them in thinking maybe it's a spawn in new ones at this point, and they might then breed, but I never saw them, like, try and make any attempts at breeding. I think from time to time when trading with them, they will have the hearts above their head, even when there's, like, several of them in a room. I'm hoping I can be heard, by the way, over all this door clanging and villager sounds, and I know my microphone has been quite loud, so I'll maybe back off a bit, actually. And yeah, so basically that, you saw nothing, basically, they just came to a complete halt in production in terms of sort of villager trading, so that's why I went ahead and sort of done this over here. And let me just see if I can't find Iron Man. I swear one of these should be called Iron Man. Has he got stuck somewhere, or No, one of these was definitely called Iron Man, I swear on it. Maybe wrong world, I guess. Anyway, getting sidetracked. So basically, what we have over here is, you'll notice, despite what I just said, tons more villagers. And there's literally two villagers in each of those, apart from the ones at the back which are empty, because that's where I'm going to show you what I've done. And yeah, if I come over here down to the first one, and if you watch Patkra on Twitch, and if you remember when he done Terra Firmacraft, or TFC Tuesdays as it was known, Pigville. There's a Pigville reference, because this pig was actually on top of the iron. Oh, I just broke that. That's not what I, that wasn't my intention. Right. There, you've got a new anvil again. Known Pigville, you're probably not like this one. But yeah, he was seen standing on top of said anvil, and yeah, thus I dubbed him Pigville. Anyway, these villagers seem to be doing a weird thing with their head that I swear they've never done before, where they just seem to like look up. I don't know if they can get them to sort of do it by flying, or if they just seem to do it in their own accord, but yeah, you'll notice he's called Cured Villager number one even. And there's some, I never knew that villagers could lean their head back like that. I swear I thought their head and neck was like attached. Like, I know they turn their heads, but I didn't think they could sort of like move their head up and down like sort of the player can. But yeah, you'll notice he's called Cure Villager because I don't think I have anything in the inventory. Do I have anything in the chest? I do. So yeah, basically what I was doing was, in each of these compartments, I was spawning a zombie, hitting it with a sharpness 5 sword, and then if it was a zombie villager, throw the splash potion of weakness on it, as well as applying the golden apple and waiting for it to be cured. Then you notice going by this name tag, Cured Villager 110 is how much I got up to through doing this, and there's Pigville's name tag. And yeah, obviously, like, this is, well, I just went down here doing these one at a time, and these weren't actually double stacked houses back then, if you ignore the top layer, so these were basically just like this, just the bottom half. But then once I'd expanded that out, I decided, rather than expanding outwards in either direction in case like they don't all load into the same chunks area, or just to see like how laggy it would get with them all in the same area or something, I guess, I decided to stack them up like this. So yeah, there's twice as many villagers in this like little bit. So there's Cured Villager 1 here, and here we have Cured Villager 61. And nope, so I meant to actually grab the stuff out of the chest. Let me go back and do that. And make sure I actually take it out of the chest properly. I'll show you the first one, and then what I'm going to do is like sit here and record me doing the rest, but speed up the video. I suppose I can leave the name tags there. And I think somewhere along here should be this, the last one that I got to in one of these. Was it you? Yeah, he's Cured Villager 110. I've not actually traded with any of these yet, but some of them do actually have fairly decent trades. I don't actually remember which one had like a good trade, but some of them do have like the diamond tools and like the like diamond armor, and so one of them even has like enchanted pickaxes, I think. It's normally these guys that have like the better trades. Let me just have a quick look before I move on. And there's some that have absolutely awful trades that, yeah, there's an example. It's not a diamond sword, but a knockback one iron sword. It's, well, I suppose for trading for it, you have to trade 4 emeralds and an iron sword to get it back with knockback, but if you don't have an enchantment set up, or if you're just too lazy to enchant, there you go. Like, if you happen to have a lot of emeralds because you happen to have a big villager system, then yeah, sure, why not? And yeah, because they're all enclosed like this, they can't breed, but then again, like, I don't think they would breed, given the fact that those ones over there didn't, and any spawned in ones from that point didn't either. And if I think I have a villager. These shouldn't spawn. Yeah, can't use spawn egg at the maximum number of villagers in the world has been reached. So yeah, that confirms that all these villagers weren't spawned in with the egg. Just in case you didn't like believe me at this point. So yeah, let me come down here to, I think this is the start of the row. Yeah, this one's always like this, the one, like this one here's 101. Making this one 41. Yeah, so basically what I do, if I get a block to stand on so I don't have to like fly. Yeah, so basically I just stand here, spawn a zombie, if he turns out to be a normal zombie, then I kill him. And then effectively just stand here doing this over and over. Sometimes it would take quite long, like this seems to be doing now that I'm recording. Other times it would be like, I might get lucky and get like the zombie villager on like the first or second attempt, or like very few attempts. And sometimes they look a bit deceiving, like they look like actual zombie villagers, but the zombie villagers have the bigger heads, so you just have to pay attention for that when doing this. And yeah, there's not really much. Oop, is that one? He looks like. Nope, he doesn't have a bigger head. Yeah. And yeah, this one here. Nope. Nope. Keep going then. It's like I don't want to accidentally kill a zombie villager when I do finally get one, which is why I'm a bit hesitant than usual. And nope. For a moment I thought I had hit one. What are you then? Are you just a normal villager or? Because I have actually had the zombie baby villagers as well through doing this. And yeah, here's another. Oh, I see, here's another one. I swear that one just dropped an iron ingot. Yeah, it's like now that I'm recording. Oh, he's got a lot of armor on, so you're gonna take more than two hits to kill. And yeah, they end up having a lot of sort of. It's a good thing I'm in creative, because I almost. That would have been a waste of potion. Wow, these villagers are really. Nope. It's a bit deceiving as well in the fact that the wood almost looks like their nose from the sides, but it's not the case. It would help with. Aha! Finally! Let me just, can I grab all the stuff out of here? I about broke that there, and that would have been bad. I don't want to. Wait, if I just briefly. In fact, I'll get the stuff later, or. It doesn't really matter anyway about the things that are in there. But yeah, so basically at this point, I'll just throw the potion on them, and then apply the golden apple, and. So after a bit of time, they sort of turn into the zombie villager. Let me just grab a. You know, in creative now you get this. You'll notice I've made this out of the acacia plant, the acacia wood, and the dark oak woods. Various bits because they're only available in creative at the moment. Whereas, like on the PC one, they're obviously like part of the world generation. But I suppose that'll be a like future update on here one day. And yeah, I guess it doesn't really matter about the stuff there that I don't think I have a chest, or do I? Let me just fly over here and make sure I open rather than mine. Yeah, it doesn't matter. I suppose I could chuck that in there for what it's worth and keep that back. And just whilst I'm here, this was just me trying to be a bit creative with redesigning the sort of villagers well. Like, I was thinking I'd maybe have, like, if I was to make, like, a proper village for either them or maybe even these guys, that I'd maybe have, like, a sort of fancy looking well in the middle or something. But yeah, let's get back over there. I know it takes, like, a few mods for them to transfer, which is why I'd often sort of, like, I'd come over here to the next one and just sort of continue doing what I was doing, really. I just stand here and repeat the process over and over until like all of these are filled in, and that's effectively how it got to this point. I guess I don't really need to do a sped up part. Oh, and that's a zombie villager. Yeah, look how quickly I got that one. So yeah, there's two on the go now. Let's see if we can't get a whole row on the go, I suppose, whilst I'm recording here. And that was the wrong one. I bet you this one's going to be like 20 again or something before it's actually a zombie villager, so I'll just spam these in, just seeing as the other two are turning into villagers. See if I can't get a third one whilst they're doing so. And make sure I don't actually kill any, because yeah. Now I'm trying to do it a bit quicker just because the video's getting on a bit and I don't want this to be like a big long video. But yeah, whilst doing this, I know this isn't like looking at this is like easily done in creative, like it does take time, but it can be done like to this extent and can probably be done to as much villagers as your heart's content or as much hours as you're willing to put into it. And that's a normal villager. But yeah, I suppose like in terms of a creative world, in terms of a survival world setup, it's not quite a viable solution in the long run, and you probably will get enough trades out of the villagers you have, or like through killing them to breed new ones to get better trades, but if you did want to have a big villager setup and you happen to have either a zombie spawn or a sort of mob grinder or zombie grinder, then you could sort of have a way of like separating the zombie villagers out from the rest through like maybe a piston setup or something. I had actually thought about doing that on the video before just to like show off a setup like that, but I guess I'll leave anyone watching to do that. And wow, this just really doesn't want to spawn a zombie villager this time. They do still spawn, but as I said, it's just, you've got chain armor. As I said, it's just luck that sometimes they'll spawn after a few, sometimes they'll take all day to spawn in. And almost thought that was one then. But you can tell because the head kind of pops up more, like it comes up through into like the dip in the roof that I've made, whereas normal zombies, they don't really have that going on for them. They're still going. I guess I'll keep going. Don't mean this one was just a zombie villager. That one is a zombie villager though, thankfully. So we'll throw the potion on you. Can do that. And yeah, there's another one. So we have three. Nope. I say we have three, but we now have another villager. Let's grab the name tag and dump him. Secured villager 111. Has another anvil there. Maybe even a potential pig fell too there. I'm just going to nudge you onto the anvil, and there you go, pigville. And there's the slime. Right, so let's grab, not this one, let's grab this one. And if I can get into the anvil, chuck that in there. And yeah, this is cured villager 111. Obviously, in terms of naming them in a survival world, you would suppose if you have a grinder, experience isn't too much of a worry, but no. But at the same time, hang on. I just had to clear my throat a bit there, as you can tell. And yeah, might have to. Can I? No, I might have to put a block back down again. Cause you have to sort of shift click to. There we go, cured villager number 111. Or 111 if you want. And I broke all the way through to the grass as well, it seems. But yeah, there is a noticeable lag after a while in terms of that the gameplay no longer becomes as smooth, even when going sort of slowly. I don't know, it seems to vary. Sometimes you'll, maybe it's like how many villagers you're looking at, or it just seems to like vary, like I said, like sometimes it'll be quite jittery, other times it seemingly like fairly smooth like it is now, so it just seems to be a thing. And let's go back and sort of quickly rename this one as well. I do actually have this world transferred over to the Xbox One as well to show off the fact that it actually runs better on there, but I don't think I need to bother with actually showing that on the video, and I can't actually remember if I did sort of finish like filling in these last villagers along there or not. I think I might have left them empty, which would mean having to transfer this again anyway if I wanted to sort of have these new ones in there. And just let's see if I can't get this name to change before he's thinking. Pigville's still hanging out on his iron anvil, I see. At the same time kind of blocking me from getting in to use it. Yes, I'd like to rename the Oakwood plank stacks. And yeah, this'll be 113 then. No, 113, I pressed start there instead of 3. Right, let's fly back over. And fly right past him. Right, we'll keep that there for when he's done. We'll see what this one's got. So this one is another gold ingot trade. So, what is it? Ah, so you have to trade him 9 gold ingots for an emerald, so that's actually quite rubbish. Like, the 9 gold ingots are kinda worth more, but I know that if you're sort of breeding or getting villagers on this scale, you'll be getting quite a lot of emeralds as a whole from them, so you might end up having emeralds to actually buy better things in the long run. Whereas, like, what does he have? There's like quite a lot of the sort of the red trades in there, and there's one that's sort of 12 emeralds for an iron chest plate, so that's not too bad, I guess. Oh yeah, that's 13, sorry. That looked like 12 there just at first glance. But yeah, that one gets you an iron chest plate, so suppose you save iron, or like if you're sort of purely trading with villagers to see what you can get, then that's essentially free iron. And you can't melt it down on this one, like I'm thinking of like mod packs where you can sort of chuck that into like a thing and melt it down and get the iron ingots back from it, but on this one you just stick with what you've got. There's 5 emeralds for an iron hole, maybe a bit pricey, but considering that's just an iron hole. You're the breadwinner again. You could say that he's a breadwinner. Moving on. Oh, there's a good one. Efficiency 3 iron axe that, like, again, it requires an iron axe and 2 emeralds to trade, but if you think about that, you'd potentially get that. Hang on. Sorry about that, I muted my mic and I'd ask a sip of juice to try and stop my throat drying out. Or mouth drying out, I guess. But yeah, as I was saying, this one's, if you don't have an enchantment set up, then yeah, this is essentially a free enchantment for just 2 emeralds, and that's quite good, I guess. Like, I suppose for an iron axe, like, you're just going to be chopping down trees quicker, and obviously you prefer to have maybe unbreaking on there as well, but in the long run you prefer to have like an efficiency 3 sort of diamond pickaxe or efficiency 4, but I suppose if you trade a couple of these, you could sort of combine the both together and get yourself efficiency 4 and repeat again to get efficiency 5 if you so wanted, and slowly make an ultimate iron axe, I guess. Is this one done? Yes. Right, we will dub the cured villager 113. Not sure if that rhymed or not. And your trade is 30 paper for an emerald, so yeah, that's another sort of handy one, because you can, if you've got like a sustainable sugarcane farm, you're sort of going to be up to your chests, I guess, in sugarcane, so you could turn all that into paper and trade for emeralds on a mass, especially when there's like tons and tons of villagers here. And yeah, as I said, I was going to sort of do a sort of speed up footage of me filling in all these, but I guess it's not necessary because you get the idea. And like I said, in terms of survival, it's not maybe a viable solution, but it can be done, and if you're willing to put in the time, given that Minecraft is indeed a game about putting in time to get your reward, then yeah, This is what it looks like from above, by the way, between the house and all the little sort of huts, I guess. It's like a sort of oriental style looking hut, I guess. I can't remember the actual name. I can't remember their actual name now. Like, I was showing a friend these before and he did actually say the name, but yeah, it's oriental hut looking thing of some kind. And yeah, I guess that wraps up the, or well, I guess I'll wrap up the video there then. And basically, to sum it up, villager breeding only got as far as 35, I think. And oh yeah, I forgot to point out that I don't know where they are, but villager 1 and 2 were initially spawned in, because as this is a super flat world and village generations is turned off to not hinder what I was. Oh, you're 21, I thought that was 1 there, I saw the 1 and got excited. Let's move away from the noise. And yeah, villagers number 1 and 2 were spawned in with the spawn egg that you can see there. And then from that point on I just done the trading with them all just to sort of get them all in. Like, I just done the trading and then sort of sat back and let them breed, and I think I had to like keep going into like the host options here. You've seen my name on things by now anyway, so it doesn't matter. But yeah, like set in that tonight. Whereas now I've got to like set on eternal daytime, and setting it on night means they're more likely to like, seeing as they're all inside, they're more likely to breed when they're inside compared to outside. At least I think so anyway. It seemed to work effectively in that sense. And yeah, so to recap, you can spawn in two villagers. Well, in Crate, if you could spawn in two villagers into a world that doesn't have villagers, they'll breed as far as up to 35, so that's 33 additional villagers. And then you can spawn in two more additional villagers before the game then tells you that you can't spawn any more in. And these iron golems weren't, like, they weren't made by B, they actually spawned in naturally along with them, so again, you could sort of kill these if you were inhumane like that and get iron from them. And yeah, so that's the summary of that side, and the summary for this side would be sort of doing the whole sheep. I was going to say, where's Pigfell gone? He's round there. Yeah, so basically sort of spawning in a zombie, hitting them with a sword, weakness potion, golden apple. And I know in terms of survival, you don't have a spawned zombie, but you will have a good sword, and if you have a zombie grinder or a zombie spawner set up in the right way, that where you could like essentially have like flowing water coming out from them, like coming out, and maybe have it to where they're like a piston or something holding them up so that they get separated, and that way if there's a zombie villager in there, you won't be to be like swinging your sword at them all and accidentally kill it. So as far, and like from that point, like, you've got to brew your potions, which requires like ingredients, and then there's the golden apples, which I believe they're just the normal, the standard ingot form ones, as opposed to the golden notch apple that requires blocks. So I suppose it's not too bad on the gold intake, but it does require that you have a significant amount of gold per villager that you're sort of curing, especially if you plan on getting like say up to 120 or 113, as I've now got up to here. Maybe one day I'll try this out on my sort of Luxtacrass survival world, or maybe even just on a, like if I do a survival world of my own and put it to the test one day, who knows. Or I've got a survival world on with one of my friends on both this and on the Xbox One that we've been playing on the Xbox One more recently, and well, I don't know if I want to try that on there. I don't want to sort of lag out the world and potentially break the game, so we'll see. But yeah, considering the limit seems to be around about 37, counting spawned in villagers and naturally sort of bred ones from that point on, then yeah, the cured villagers seems to be a way to sort of surpass the limit. And so yeah, I was amazed at how far it got at first, like through the first layer, and I wasn't expecting to get like a double stack of these. And if I so wanted, I could essentially pull these up to the sky with, well, maybe not that high, that would take years, but another two layers on top of this and maybe go as far as 200 additional villagers. And right now you notice it's that bit laggy again, but on the Xbox One, I noticed it's a lot smoother and you don't have this issue, so it could be a thing that it might actually run better on there. And whether you'd have them set up like this in a survival, or maybe you'll have them set up in terms of like in a wall in a line or something, and have them more sort of easier to trade with, or I was going to say kill off the ones that don't have good trades, but if you've spent gold kind of bringing these things back from being a zombie villager to being a cured villager, you wouldn't necessarily want to kill them off and like waste, have your gold go to waste more than it already did. But yeah, anyway, I'm going to finish up the video here then and bring a stop for now to this villager madness. But I guess if anyone wants to try this out, then feel free. But if this becomes a thing that, like, because I looked up sort of various villager videos and between the 360 and the Xbox One, and found out that you can't in fact sort of get past the limit through natural breeding, but I've proven them wrong through, well, not proving them wrong in terms of natural breeding, but proving them wrong in terms that you can actually have more than the limit if you do the curing zombie villagers to bring them back to normal villagers. That does indeed work. But yeah, I'm going to wrap it up there after probably the third time pointing that out now. And yeah, as always, stay tuned for more videos, and thanks for watching, I guess.